Bean. All right. I heard the other day that undetectable HIV, meaning that if you get a negative on your test for HIV, you are not at risk of passing on the HIV virus. You cannot infect anybody if they cannot detect the HIV in your blood. Sort of like herpes, which is a virus, not a disease. I don't know what the exact implications are, or the comparisons and differences between the... I think one is a bacteria and the other... Yeah, never mind. Anyway, if Magic Johnson, for example, has HIV, but it's undetectable, he cannot be accused of spreading the HIV virus. How is that possible? According to the CDC, this statement is true. Undetectable HIV testing means that you are at no risk, zero risk. Not 95%, 98%, not 50%, not 20%. You are at zero risk. Which means, how is this possible that you could be charged with a crime, a felony by state? I think 20 to 30 of the 50 states have laws against the transmission of HIV. Yet, as of June 1st, 2019, this statement is true, according to the CDC, which is the Center for Disease Control and NIH.
National Institute of Health.
But it means that you can no longer transfer the disease. Now, a lot of that is based on the fact that you have to be taking your medications in order to be undetectable. So, if you're not taking your medications and you do happen to transmit the disease, you could be jailed. One of the other factors in the legal aspect of this transmission of HIV is you don't have to actually infect a person to be criminally negligible for the crime. Meaning that if you are found to have the disease, whether you knew it or not, you are in the commission of a crime or have committed a crime. That is pretty confusing and pretty disheartening. Who's right? Who's wrong? This has been another thought-provoking moment in D-World 2019.